Hello, Internet. Welcome back to the Data Science community. Last time we learned how to rename and recast our columns in Azure ML. Keep in mind that this video will assume that you have all your columns casted properly. If not, please go to watch our previous video where I will show you how to do that. Today we will learn how to project, isolate, and exclude columns, as well as how to scrub missing data from our datasets. So before we can scrub down our datasets, let's identify some columns of missing data and develop a planned approach on how we're going to deal with them. So you want to go down to your missing values row. And you'll notice the first column with missing values is age at 177 missing values, so that's about 20% of your data. But it's numeric type, so we can easily replace that with the mode, median, zero, or the mean, depending on what context. But in this context, it's age, so we might want to just replace it with the median. And then the next set we have with missing data is cabin at 687 missing values. So that's about 77% of your entire data set having a missing value for cabin. And it also doesn't hold much value right now because it's a string and it just basically represents the room number. So we could mark this as a candidate to be dropped later. So we might just drop this entire column later moving forward. And next we have embarked at 2 missing values. And since it's categorical data and there's only 2 missing values, we can easily drop these 2 rows when we scrub. So now we have our scrub strategy. For every missing value of age, we're just simply going to replace it with the median. And for cabin, we're just going to drop that entire column for now. And embarked, we're going to just drop 2 rows. So let's get to it. So you want to go over to data transformation, and under manipulation, you want to find the missing value scrubber. And then you want to just drag in your data set into the missing value scrubber. I'm actually going to copy and paste the missing value scrubber, so there's going to be 2, because I'm going to show you a good example and a bad example. Because the missing value scrubber will actually apply whatever operation you've designated to the entire data set. So let's explore the operations in the missing value scrubber. So in the missing value scrubber, you can either replace with the median, the mode, or the mean, or remove the entire row itself. So since this is a good example, on the left side, I'm going to replace all the numerical missing values with the median. And on the right side, since this is a bad example, I'm just going to remove the entire row. So I've taken the liberty of renaming these modules. So on the left side, we have NA numeric being replaced with the median. And on the right side, we have all NAs where we remove the entire rows. And let's see what happened in the bad example in the aftermath of that. So once we're in there, you notice that there's only 183 rows from our 891 rows that was originally there. So we butchered basically 80% of our data. That's really bad, because not only did it remove every unknown value for age, it also removed all the unknown rows for cabin, which was already almost 80% of our values, and also removed 2 rows of embarked. But let's check out what happened in the good example, where we just replaced numerical values with the median. The first thing you should notice that by replacing with the median is that we still retain 891 rows. That's still 100% of our data that's been retained. And you will notice that age has been reduced to 0 missing values, but also notice that cabin and embark still have their missing values. That's because they're string and they're categorical, and what we did was a numerical replacement, so they were left untouched, and that's good. We want them to be untouched for now. And you will notice that if you look at the frequency of age, the median, which was 29.36, now replaces and it's now overwhelmed the majority. So I showed you back-to-back good examples and bad examples just to show you that the ordering of the way you scrub your data actually matters a lot. So removing rows is basically the last thing you ever want to do when you're scrubbing data. So when scrubbing data in Azure ML, replacing numerical values first is what you wanted to be doing, because the mean, median, and mode in the missing value scrubber will actually ignore anything else. But also keep in mind that there is a grain of salt to that, because remember, if you did not properly cast your columns correctly, so for example, survived, we started back as numerical, and passenger ID was also numerical. So had there been missing values in survived or passenger ID, they would have also been replaced with the median. So keep in mind that doesn't make much sense. So always cast your data before you start scrubbing your missing values. The next phase of our data scrubbing is actually to remove the column cabin, because it has too much missing values in it. It doesn't have much meaning in this case. I mean, we can bin it later and it might have meaning there, but not right now. So ticket can also be removed because it doesn't make much sense, just a ticket number. We can also remove the passenger name because our models really can't interpret names into the models. And then we can also remove passenger ID because that's just the PK of this database. So let me show you how to do that. So to do that, you want to go into transform again under manipulation. You want to go to a module called project columns module. And what this column does is it lets you project part of the table to it. So think of it as a subquery. So this is where you get to pick what tables stay and which tables go. So now that you have the project columns module dragged in, just connect it to your continued flow of work data. So there's actually a number of ways you can do this. So I'm just going to copy and paste to project columns and show you two ways to do this. You can either include all the columns and then list individual columns that you want to exclude. So this one I'm going to show you where I'm going to include all columns and then just exclude the ones I don't want. So I don't want passenger ID to be included. I don't want name to be included, nor do I want ticket or cabin. So those columns are basically going to be dropped, and it's going to be all the rest of the columns moving forward. And on this side, I'm not going to have any columns included in the beginning. I'm going to show which columns I want to include individually. So I want survived, accommodation class, sex, age, sibling, spouse, parent, child, fare, and embarked. All right, so let's run that. On the right side, where we just included individual columns, so we have 8 columns. And on the other side, where we just chose to exclude certain columns and include the rest of them, we also have 8 columns. So they both outputted the same result. However, I prefer the result that makes you basically document the least. So on this side, we only had to select 4 columns to exclude, versus on this side, we had to choose 8 columns to include. So I'm going to go forward with the exclude because there's less exclude than there is include. So I'm just going to remove that, and then I'm going to comment that. So I'm just going to rename this really quick. When that's done, you can actually see in your data that there's much less columns. So we went from 12 columns down to 8 columns. And now we have 0 missing values except for embarked. So now that when we actually remove the rows from embarked, we don't have to worry about any collateral damage because there won't be any. The only missing values left to remove are the 2 left in embarked. Let's remove those last 2 rows. So I'm just going to copy and paste my missing value scrubber from up here. So now I'm going to have 2 missing value scrubber, and then I'm just going to reroute the pathing. So now it's going to go down, and I'm going to change it to remove entire row. And then I'm just going to run the model. When that's done running, let's see what happens when we visualize it. So as you can see here, we've successfully removed all of our missing values while at the same time retaining basically all of our data. We just lost 2 rows. In conclusion, when you're scrubbing missing data from your datasets, these are the 4 steps you should generally follow. First, you want to cache your columns into direct typing. Then you want to scrub down to numerics, followed by projecting or removing the proper columns that you don't want added, and then you want to remove the rows last. And that concludes part 2 of preprocessing and scrubbing missing data from our datasets. Join us next time where I will show you how to feature engineer your datasets, as well as introduce you to the R script module in Azure ML.
If you like what you just saw, subscribe to our channel or leave us a comment. Let us know if there's a topic you want us to cover, and be sure to check us out at datasciencedojo.com. Until next time.